Hi everyone, my name is Amita and I am a customer engineer in the Identity Advanced Customer Engineering team. In this video, I will be talking about troubleshooting login issues on Azure AD and hybrid AD joined devices. I am assuming you already have a Windows 10 or 11 AD join or hybrid AD join device, but are looking for further troubleshooting information on sign-in issues. Talking about the user experience during sign-in issues, you might see Windows login failures in Azure AD join scenario, or receive repeated sign-in prompts or conditional access errors as there is an issue with the PIT or token acquisition. There could be multiple possible reasons for these issues, such as line of sight to the domain controllers or TPM errors. To start the troubleshooting process, you could utilize the DSreg CMD command line utility to understand the state of devices in Azure Active Directory. The DSreg CMD slash status utility must be run as a domain user account. Let me show how to run the command and how the output looks like on AD and hybrid AD joined devices respectively. We will also run through its parameters to understand how they could be leveraged to troubleshoot login issues. The first parameter to focus on is device state. It has been there since the beginning of Windows AD join and hybrid AD join. It provides you information about the current state of the device based on the below values. If Azure AD joined is set to yes and remaining parameters as no, that means the device is Azure AD joined. However, if the values of both Azure AD joined and domain joined is yes, that indicates that the device is hybrid Azure AD joined. Please note that in AD join scenario, both AD join and enterprise join cannot be true. Secondly, you can get more information about the device under Device Details section. For example, the device ID, which is the unique ID of the device in the Azure AD tenant, or device auth status for Windows devices post 2.1H1 version, which performs a check to determine the device health in Azure AD. As you see on the screen, these are the device details captured from the DSreg CMD slash status command output. For further details, please visit the Troubleshooting Hybrid Azure AD Joined Devices link in the description section. Particularly when troubleshooting the login issues, the SSO parameter is highly useful because it indicates if the primary refresh token is present for the logged-in user along with the timestamp and additional details as shown in the sample output here. Let's talk a bit more about PIT. A primary refresh token is a key artifact of Azure AD authentication on Windows 10 or newer, Windows Server 2016 and later versions, iOS and Android devices. It's a JSON web token specially issued to Microsoft first-party token brokers to enable single sign-on across the application used on those devices. In AD join scenarios, the value of Azure AD PIT should be set to yes. However, in hybrid AD join scenario, the device could have a PIT from both Azure AD and on-premises Active Directory simultaneously. In a failed scenario, you would see the value of Azure AD PRT set to no like this. To sum up, DSreg CMD slash status provides you with the holistic status of the current join status along with the tenant details. It also provides you the diagnostic information and error codes for further troubleshooting. You could find additional information about these error codes in the documentation referenced in the description section. Now let's talk about the DSreg tool, which is a comprehensive tool performing more than 50 different tests to help you identify and fix the most common device registration issues for all join types. It runs different tests, such as testing the OS information or connectivity to the domain controller. To run this tool, please download it from the link in the description section. To start the DSreg tool, please run the start-auth partial script from the auth folder. You can now reproduce the issue to capture the required data. Once the issue is reproduced, please go back and run the stop-auth script to stop the data collection. It collects comprehensive information used for diagnostic purposes, but the first one would be to get the error code from AAD analytics and operational logs. The operational log is more about the overall authentication process, whereas the analytic log provides further debug information. The analytic and operational log events are both required to troubleshoot issues. For example, in my AAD operational logs, I can see error code 400 received from Azure AD, which indicates a bad request. The next error code indicates that the network was unreachable to provide further insight into the issue. Finally, if you are facing login issues in your AAD join or hybrid join devices, you could also go to Azure portal and click on Diagnose SSO Problems, and you will see useful documentation pertaining to the SSO issues. In a nutshell, we learned about user experience during sign-in issues and various tools to perform initial analysis such as DSReg CMD or DSReg tool. We'll be sharing the reference documentation links in the description section for your further reading. Thanks for watching.